That's number one. Invest in what you know. Somebody told me, every time we hear the word invest, it often pertains to the stock market or making money or whatever it is. Let me understand, that's not my area of expertise. Don't ask me for what to invest in. I don't. I pay people for that. Okay? I have no idea what you should or should not invest in. That's up to you. But there'll come a time when you learn about it and you'll have more knowledge of one thing over another, and I encourage you to put your funds wherever that is. But however, I will pose a question to you. If we're speaking about investing in what you know, who do you know better than you know yourself? If we invest in what we know, who do you know better than you know yourself? Okay? In order to become the best version of yourself, you should take all your time, efforts, and energy and invest it into you. That doesn't cost money. It costs absolutely nothing. Time studying, time giving back, improving your intellectual capacity, vocabulary, and many other things help you ultimately receive the best return on any investment that you could ever make. Yourself. Period. Point blank. If you're willing to take a day off, you should be just as willing to take an extra day on. And I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Every day you feel comfortable with selling yourself short, because they are inevitable, understand, it's part of life. You should be just as willing to have an extra day of pushing yourself just a little bit longer, because the payoff of going a little bit longer is much greater than ever selling yourself short. That's number one, invest in yourself. Because the more you give into yourself, the more you put into yourself, the more you're going to get out of your life. You can give time to money, cars, clothes, friends, family, Instagram, Snapchat. You can give time to houses, whatever you want to give time to. But if you don't first invest in yourself, your return will never be as great as it can be. So number one is invest in yourself. Number two is this, be fearless. Be absolutely fearless. I read a book and it said when you live in fear, you hold on to what you have because you don't trust that there is more. When you live in fear, you hold on to what you have because you don't trust that if I go through that door of opportunity, there won't be more for me. This is more comfortable for me here. If I go through to my next opportunity, I don't really know what's going to be over there. It may be a step up from where I'm at, but right here, right now, this is where I'm comfortable. So be fearless. Hear me when I say it. Be fearless. Okay, understand. There's a difference between belief and trust. The key word is because they don't trust that there's more. See, through Boys Hope, Girls Hope, we all believe that there's more. I think we'd all be in agreement that our lives have been changed tremendously to believe that there's more. But will you trust the process? Will you trust everything that goes into that belief? See, belief is relying upon things that you cannot see. Trust is founded in these things that you can, that you believe in, that you know to be true. Will you trust it? I'm here to help you trust. Nick is here to help you trust. There are plenty of alumni floating around this country, this world, to help you trust. So be fearless. Be fearless. There were times when I was in college, I had no idea that I was going to graduate, but I trusted every bit of the process, and I graduated early. See, it's inevitable that we will hit a point in our lives where we may believe but not trust, and at that moment, I beg you to be fearless. There are few inhibitors to one's growth other than the constraints of fear. There are few inhibitors to one's growth other than the constraints of fear. Fortunately, these constraints, they're not concrete. They're very much just abstract thoughts of the mind. And each and every last one of you are in control of those. Don't be scared to be great. Don't be scared to go against the grain. Be fearless, last thing, first thing, invest in yourself, be fearless, last thing, don't you ever quit. And I mean that from the bottom of my soul, don't you ever quit, ever. Don't let anybody, anywhere, tell you what you can't do, ever. Spring 2005, I almost quit. December 2009, I almost quit. October 2010, I almost quit. April 2013, same thing. November 2015, I almost quit. February 2017, they thought that we were going to quit. I don't tell you these things, I don't tell you these dates to brag on myself, but I'm telling you, let you know that I'm just like you. Even with everything that I've been blessed with in my life, there have been times where I wanted to give up, and this is proof. There are still times where I want to give up, but I won't ever quit. God puts us through things so that when somebody else goes through the same situation, we can bless them with our experience about how we didn't give up. This is what I did to succeed, and this is what you'll do to be better. So I'm saying to you, don't ever quit. Don't ever quit. You may slip. You may slip, you may take a step back, but I pray to God, don't you ever, ever, ever quit. Ever. First thing, invest in yourself. Second thing, be fearless. Last thing, don't you ever quit. I'm glad that all of y'all are here. We're all in this together. We are all in this together. I promise you we are. From New York to Peru, Cincinnati to New Orleans, we're all in this together. We're all going through it. When I'm in New York, I expect them to hold me down, and when y'all in Cincinnati, y'all know I got y'all back. Understand, we are all in this together. There is nobody who can do this alone. Your legacy will be talked about when you're not here. Let us do the talking about your legacy. Let the world do the talking about your legacy. But while you're here on this earth, you fulfill your purpose. Your legacy is for when you're gone, but on this earth, it's about fulfilling your purpose. As y'all embark on this journey, man, I hope each and every last one of y'all fulfill your purpose and lay a concrete foundation for a great legacy. I love each and every last one of y'all. I'm so proud of y'all for what y'all doing. It's why I go to bat. It's why I go through the airports and rental car services and whatever. I love y'all to death. And if there's anything that y'all never need from me, I got business cards on me. Please, don't hesitate to call. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Cool. Thanks.